Grandma and Grandpa had a recipe, and Grandpa was the first chef, my father second chef, and I'm the third chef, and hopefully my children will follow, we'll see. And Grandpa always used only veal. Now, I know a lot of Italian people use veal, beef, and pork.
Right.
Nothing wrong with it. It's your recipe. It's just a little different. But Grandpa used veal, and the veal has a little more gelatin, so it stays moist.
Okay.
Everyone loves the meatballs. So, very simple recipe, a little still chopped veal. We'll put some salt and pepper.
You never see measuring cups in a great chef.
No.
Did you ever notice that? They
no.
throw it in, and then you get home and try it. What happened?
It works. It works. It works. Pinch of oregano.
Okay.
Some fresh parsley chopped up. And I have breadcrumbs, but you could use bread if you want, soaked in water as well. Pecorino Romano cheese, but if you like Parmesan Reggiano, it's all you know, your flavor. A couple of eggs. And then some garlic inside.
God,
of course, you got to have some garlic in there. And Frank Sinatra loved it, too, but with him was whole garlic. Whole garlic in and out, any recipe we would do like that.
He didn't like you to shave it up.
No, 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 he wouldn't do that.
Maybe I should try that, help the chops, you know what I mean?
No, no, you're a great singer, come on. Don't be silly.
I know.
Yeah.
No, no, I'm kidding.
I love this guy. He really is a nice guy, by the way. I'm telling you, he really is. And we mix it in, and you know what? I'm going to use my hands.
Jerry, you watching this?
Like this here.
Jerry Weld is drooling over there.
We're going to have a lot of fun. It's going to be a lot of fun, good stuff. You could form them with your hands if you like, or we have a little scoop here as well.
You don't ever use that scoop, do you?
Not really.
Yeah.
I'm being honest with you.
He also eats ice cream with his hands, which is unusual.
That's something different. Yeah. And you put them in the oil and we fry them.
And that's it.
And get them a little fried. Now, also, we made a tomato sauce. This
Yum.
Is my grandmother Conchetta's tomato basil sauce. Onions, garlic, a little red wine, some bay leaf. And some boiled tomatoes. And what's the key? Everyone says, what's the key to a good sauce? Well, your main ingredient is tomato. Don't overcook it. Some people think you got to cook a sauce 3, 4, 5 hours. No. A regular marinara tomato basil, this should take you no more than a half an hour. And
you're
it keeps
kidding.
The freshness of the tomato is perfect. And if you want a shortcut, we actually do jar our sauce. We sell in all the supermarkets around the country
That's
and on our
stuff.
Website. It makes a quick, easy way to do it for you. And it's just a lot of fun to continue in the tradition of my grandparents.
I bet. It's an honor, right?
Oh, yes, of course. Now we're going to get to taste some as well.
I'm sorry, guys. I hate the... they're all grumbling and stuff, mad at me.
Oh, we're sorry. We wish it was smell of it.
Oh, my God. Good. You know what's great about My dad, he's 91. He likes simple food. A lot of times people, they try to, you know, make, you know...
Fancy something?
Yeah, and this is... It's classic, it's simple, and it doesn't get any better.
Stick to your ribs, there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, I like the fancy stuff as well, but there's nothing wrong with the classics.
It's really good.
Also, we did make some cannolis, which, right?
Why does everybody sound Italian all of a sudden? Oh, <man. laughs> Just like that.
Leave the gun, take the cannolis, right? So, and
I
you
like
know,
that.
A lot of people are gluten-free now, so if they don't want it in the cannoli shell, what we do is we serve it with fresh strawberries.
That's
you
beautiful.
Just dip the strawberries in there as well. Right. So it's a great thing. And the really good news, I think you told them, is we got the Patsy's Italian Cookbook, and everyone in the audience is going home right now.
I love it. And if you at home want to learn how to make these great recipes, go to harrytv.com. Thank you, Sal.